Hey guys, so in this video I just wanted to show you quickly this new app that I've come across. It's called Watches app. So I've done previous videos where I show you how to install WhatsApp, but from what I've seen so far and the various apps available, I think this is probably the best one to install WhatsApp onto your watch. So if we just have a look at the app here, we can see it has a premium version and a free version, and is certain things allowed that you can do in the premium, like send voice notes and stuff. And we could see $6.49 for 6 months or $11.99 for the year, and you get 3 days free trial, but we'll check that out, what that includes later. But for now, let's just install it onto the watch and we will have a look at the free version and see what we get with that. So once you download the app, it automatically installs onto the watch. So I've got it here on one of my complications, and as always, the common procedure is to get the QR code, head over to your WhatsApp in settings, go to link a device, authenticate your login, and then simply scan the QR code on the watch and it will register that. Just takes a few seconds to log in and then you're all set. So if you come out of there and head over to the watch, and we can see right here that we have the conversations straight away, and we can see only the three conversations is keeping at the top, so your previous three and the rest are locked. Swipe to the left, we go to settings, so there's different things there, and then if you swipe over to the right, you can start a new chat with all of your contacts in your phone here, but obviously in this free version we can't access that. So I'm just gonna have a look at this conversation that I've been having myself for test purposes, and we can see here previous messages. You have your different keyboards on the bottom, and we can see this voice note locked out there. Test the messaging out. Simple enough with the full QWERTY keyboard that we have available on the watch series 7. And if I just, these are links that I had sent to myself, and if you long press on anything, you can reply directly to that message. And again, pick your keyboard, and I'll show you how I can change this later so that it only shows up with certain keyboards. And if we just go back to settings, you can pick your keyboards from here, so you can turn off the ones that you don't want to show up, and then we can see that there's the voice note and location settings if you want to drag them somewhere else. So if I just head back, and now we can see it's got that one keyboard that I picked now. Type a quick message. Right, so looks like the free version's okay. You can't play voice notes on this, so I'm gonna run the free trial on the paid subscription, premium membership, and let's head back to the Apple Watch. And now if we have a look, we can see all the conversations are available, and I'm just gonna scroll through here, try playing this voice note. Okay, not playing. Let me try sending a voice note. Okay, let's try with sharing your location. So it's obviously going to ask you if you want to use the settings, and then you can send location. So yep, looking at it on the phone, we can see that it's shared the location, so that's fine. And let me try the voice note now. So allow it access to the microphone, so it starts recording straight away. Record your message and then you can cancel or send. So let's just send that. Looks like that's sent, and yep, that's come through. Seems to be working. So if we just have a look, I want to see if it plays on the watch. Yeah, it does. So you can see it's play. You can choose the speed, you can adjust the volume, so you can use the crown to adjust the volume. So that was a quick note, it come out of there. But previous voice notes that I've sent don't seem to be playing. Maybe I would have to just reset the app or come out of it and go back into it. But we can see that the one I just done is working. Right, so let's just have a look at what media looks like when you send it across. So I'm gonna just send this screenshot that I took, and I just wanna see what it comes up as in the conversation. So we can see it's come up here. So you can tap to zoom, you can use the digital crown to zoom in and out, and you can move around to explore. So oh, that looks good. Yep, you can move around. but that seems to be working fine. I'm going to try it with a short video here. So it looks like that's sent through. Send back to the watch. And it's come through. So just play that. It's going to take a few seconds to load. And yeah, that seems to be working fine. And again, you can control the volume with the digital crown. So that's all good. And let me just send over a GIF to see what that's like. So I'm just going to trim this video down in order to get it to a length to be able to send as a GIF. You can see there, GIF, GIF, whatever you call it. I don't know if that debate's ever been settled. So that's sent across. And I'll head back to the conversation on the watch. And yep, that seems to come through, so it's not automatic playing like it would on the phone, but you can still go in and play it on the watch, so that's absolutely fine. So let me just check. If we head over to contacts, you can see here you can scroll through your contacts using the alphabet on the right, so that's handy. If we go to the settings, let's just have a quick look at quick replies. So you can pick the keyboard. I'm just going to put a generic on here. Okay, no problem. Save that. And if we go back to the conversation and choose keyboard, oh, so it's changed the keyboard settings now. So we've got voice dictation. Let's just do that. Testing this keyboard. Yep, that's fine. That worked perfectly. So if I just adjust the keyboards here, I'm going to turn them all back on so we can just have a look at all the keyboards that are available. Obviously with Apple Watch Series 7 or WatchOS 9 you get the full QWERTY keyboard, but if you don't, I guess you're allowed to use the classic keyboard here, the T9 keyboard. So I'll just have to remember how many times to be hitting the keys. Too many times there. So that works fine as well by the looks of it. And if I just quickly have a look at how it works logging out, so literally scroll to the bottom of the settings, click on log out and give it a few seconds to log out. It's gone back to the main QR code screen. And if I just bring it up on WhatsApp here, I can see it still says it's linked, but I guess if you just click on it and go in there to log it out, to totally disconnect the app. And if I show you quickly, you do get a complication with this app as well. So if you just edit the watch face here, scroll across to complications, and I had already set it here, but just for the sake of showing you, you can click on it and set it here, so it's just easy access to the app whenever you need, straight from your watch face that you have set. So that's nice and convenient. Overall, out of all the apps that I've used for WhatsApp on the Apple Watch, I think this has been my favorite one. Justifying the price isn't too bad, $6.49, whatever currency that works out to be in your country, but overall I have enjoyed this app. Thank you for watching, guys. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Take care.